Sometimes I walk around when the sun is going down and the lights inside the big buildings and homes come on. Sometimes I can see the people inside going about their business. I imagine the lives that go on behind the glowing windows that separate us. I always carry this book with me on these walks. I know every word of every sentence by heart. I carried it tonight as I walked past the glares of the other people who live on the streets. I carried it close to me, imagining the magic within its dog-eared pages, lighting up the lives of the people I pass. Tonight I met a beautiful girl living on the streets. She looked so sad.
Hello.
They call me Silent.
I'm Anna.
I can make you happy. Here, read my book. The words are magic. Then she started to cry.
But I can't see. I'm blind.
I sat down next to her. Then listen. Let me tell you a story. You're in Little Italy, New York. I used to live there when I was a mute.
Tomorrow will be too late. It's now or never, my love.
He stole books from Zamboni's bookstore and used the pages to cook and keep us warm.
Gotta read every freaking page. Let's just cut these suckers.
It's now or never.
Silence says that the slow road only works when you comprehend your fuel.
Hey, I don't care nothing about no slow roads, okay? I just want to eat!
Aw, oh, come on, we're all hungry here.
One for you?
One for me!
Our press.
Sarah, it's Robert.
Oh.
You never called me back about that novel I sent you.
This is business, honey. It's not charity.
I'm starting a whole new life, and this time I'm going to write a real love story.
Your love stories are like dry branches, Robert.
Well, this one's going to be different. I swear. You'll see. So I'll talk to you this week.
Goodbye, Robert.
Bye, Sarah.
It was in this bookstore that Alex found the magic pop-up book. Its secret had been waiting a long time.
In Spain and 100 years here.
You have been a ghost for too long.
You miss being a human?
Lavinia. Oh. Lavinia, I am losing hope.
Don't worry, mon chéri. Someone will buy this book and open it to the right page. And you will be able to redeem yourself.
Yes.
And you will repair a broken love. And the curse will disappear. And we will be free souls.
Casanova was killed by a jealous husband and banished to the pages of this book with his lover. Bound in chains so that Casanova can't feel the pleasure of her arms around him.
Watch your step. Mm. Slippery.
Come on.
Bye, Lucy. Love to the wife.
Robert had written a love story. It was awful. He was an insensitive clod, and he was divorcing his wife to write a book. We always gave him a bad time, just to drive him crazy. Robert was a man with an overwhelming desire to write, but he didn't take the time to develop his talent. Claudia was a naturally talented painter who had little desire for recognition.
You know, my grandfather used to say it was a good sign when a puppy came into the household.
Really?
It meant the child is on the way. You know, I may be old and a little crippled, but I haven't lost my memory. Happy birthday, Claudia.
Thank you.
You know, I have art galleries all over the world. So I know. I have the eye. I know true talent. This here. Very good.
It just sort of poured out of me one afternoon.
Genius. This is genius.
Thank you.
I would like to buy all the paintings that you produce. Tarot cards say this is good that I invest in you.
Really?
You do ducks?
No.
Little baby chickens?
No, I just do people.
Yeah, no matter. Still, very good. Very good. Goodbye, my darling.
Bye.
I have to go now. All right. This, right here, this. Very scary, scary.
I told you you were talented. Aren't you excited? It's great. Really. Ellie, the marriage is officially over. Forget about my brother, Claudia. He's giving you an opportunity. Start a whole new life.
God, Hilly.
Open up.
It's not a good day,
Hilly. Robert? He's a boy.
Robert, you're the brother.
Nice to meet you. It's not a good
day. Claudia upstairs.
Please.
Is Miss here? Yes, and he has a little present for you.
A present? He's gonna do a seance for you. Hilly, I'm not in the mood for these childish games right now.
Claudia, I think it's a really good idea if you go along with this. Now listen, he's a little esoteric, he's a big child, but his connections, Claudia. Ooh la la, come on.
Hilly, what have you been telling this guy?
Bobby, we're gonna go downstairs so that we don't disturb Grampy. Come on, he's gonna do a seance for us. Here.
No.
Yes.
No. Claudia is very tired, and I'd like to get a little reading done.
Robbie?
I'm not tired. I'm not tired at all, you guys.
Come on, the dog's freezing. We're not going to sleep here. We're just going to get a little fuel, right?
It was a cold night. We went to get more fuel for the...
Ready?
Yes.
Very good.
I need a light.
That night, our lives would change forever.
Sonny, shh. What are you doing? Hey, hey, hey.
What are you looking for?
Hey, hey. Shh. Doing. What'd you find? What are you looking at? Watch out! Oh, Silent, you okay?
Silent?
Are you all...
Hey, hey, how's he supposed to answer? The guy's a mute. Quiet! I'll get him out of there! Silent! Come on. Get out of there!
An old bookstore is a perfect temple for contacting the spirits. Ladies and we must believe.
Oh, we believe.
With me as one.
You're gonna set off the smoke alarm.
Bobby.
Gates of hell, open wide. Set free your chosen ones, those who repose in the pages of history books. Show yourselves to your humble sons.
Oh, my God. How did you do that?
Spirits, give us another sign.
Quick, out of the way!
Oh, my God. Careful.
Oh! Oh!
Robert. Robert. Oh, my God. Oh, Robert. Help me, help me!
It's a metaphysical phenomenon of great significance. The books falling from shelves. Shelves toppling over. Very powerful spirits reside here.
You almost burned down my bookstore.
Do you need a doctor or anything, Robert?
No,
I don't need a doctor.
Electricity is back.
I think it's time to go.
Oh,
you
see your
hand.
Come on, let's go.
Okay.
Let's go. Please. I'll go get you some ice.
Spagnol, are you the owner of this place? Ma cosa fai? Ma cosa fai? Ma che cos'è? Ma dammelo, ma fammelo vedere, ma tese! Oh, you are a mute! I like men with a short tongue, eh? My secret would be safe with you. Do me a favor. Give me your clothes. Ciao.
Ciao. Grazie, amico. Ciao. Ciao.
Bye.
Oh, que puta. Oh.
Ancora buona Casanova,
Sbaventare un po', una cosa l'altra, così, così.
Beh, questo mondo, che grandezza. Ma ti dico,
sì, un po' di fica, un po' di questo, un po' d'altro, ecco. Sì.
Who's there? There in a house almost completely free from love. That Casanova himself was released from the pages of the book. Now he had to unite the forces of true love or be condemned forever to the pages of history.
Right here. That's it. Right there.
What is this? What is this? My great-grandfather started this bookstore, and it's been handed down over three generations, and I will absolutely not allow anyone to sell it. I'm doing this for your future. Yours and Claudia's.
Grandpa, you might as well know the truth. Claudia and I have gotten a divorce. We're splitting up the property. I get the bookstore and she gets the house. But that way, you can live out the rest of your days where you grew up. Now please, let us all start over again. Grandpa, please! Grandpa!
I wouldn't recommend a hospital stay. He needs plenty of rest at home, surrounded by the people who know and love him.
Robert. Promise me you won't tell him about the divorce.
Remember Thanksgiving Day, and the priest already gave me my last rites, and I was feeling better, and I was hungry for turkey? It's all thanks to your husband, or should I say, ex-husband. When he told me about the divorce, There was a big shock in me. It was just what the doctor ordered, because it must have unblocked something. Look, the pain is absolutely all gone. Oh, here is Jack. He just arrived from Italy, where he's seeking his first fortune.
Seeking his fortune? In our house?
My great-grandfather came over from Italy in tattered pants and holes in his shoes. So don't judge. Anyway, Jack's going to give me a hand in the bookstore.
May I wash my clothes, please?
Sure, Jack. There's a laundromat right down the street.
My grandfather came here with tattered clothes and holes in his shoes. If I hear that one more time.
I'm here to help you, Robert.
How did you get in here?
I am a ghost. I was freed yesterday. Grazie, grazie a Dio.
Yeah, a ghost. Great. Why don't you walk through the door on your way out?
Amico mio, I prefer
the subtle pleasure of speaking without moving my lips.
Clever trick.
Next thing you know, he'll be telling us he saw the Virgin Mary, too.
Ciao, Robert.
You and I are very similar, Robert.
I was a misunderstood my whole life. And now, now that I am dead, now that I am a non-person, in limbo, I am still misunderstood. Roberti, ma dove vai? I, too, was a writer of the 18th century. Robertino, I moved in circles of splendor and luxury. I died in poverty, it's true. But I wrote dozens of novels and never got any credit. For example, I wrote this.
No, you didn't. Casanova wrote this.
Nonsense. Casanova was talented with women, yes. But he could barely spell his own name. I did all the writing for him. I followed him everywhere. I gave him all my ideas. And then, when he didn't need me anymore, he murdered me and took all of the credit.
That's absurd.
Look! Stabbed by a dagger from Bellini and Sentis of Venice. Mind you, he's the best swordsmith in Italy.
Is it possible?
I was his ghostwriter, Robert.
If you just rubbed elbows with him, you would make you a master, a legend.
Maybe. But now I am a poor, lost soul. And the only way to find peace is by helping a poor writer. Someone like you. And Robert, your writing needs lots and lots of help.
That's my best work.
Lots and lots of help. Help.
Could you explain to them who you were?
Not exactly.
Giacomo. If you cannot reunite a couple, we will be damned forever.
It's a very complicated case.
You remember, it must be pure love. Do not confuse sex with love. Don't make your usual mistake.
Don't worry, Lavinia.
It's very, very bad.
I barely understand English. You speak Italian. You must have missed some of the nuances.
Are you trying to insult my intelligence?
No. I'm sorry. I've just worked so hard on this, spent so much time. Every moment I have, I spend writing my novel. If you'll help me, I'll rewrite the whole thing, starting from the very beginning.
Good. Now, Robert, if you want to write about seduction and love,
you needed to learn and feel passion, love, and seduction. Now, imagine that your house is at the backdrop of the book.
Yeah.
Tonight, after a romantic dinner with Claudia, you seduce her, and tomorrow you write about it.
No. I can't do that with Claudia. We just got divorced. Now, she'd think I was trying to get back together.
Robert, you have no choice but to seduce Claudia. Casanova would have done the same thing. He would have seduced his wife, the maid, his own sister if he had to.
I know. I got it. You seduce Claudia, and then I'll observe and write about it like you did with Casanova.
No.
Why?
I have no experience with modern women. And besides, if you want to be a good writer, you have to learn how to sacrifice.
I'm willing to sacrifice anything to get this novel in that bookstore window.
Good, Robert. Good. So let's tonight be the first experiment.
God damn it.
Let me do it.
Yes, sir.
Can you wash this, please? This is going to have to be washed, yes. Kind of reminds me of when we were first going out.
Robert, ever since that bookshelf fell on you, you've been acting so strange.
Well, now that we're divorced, having dinner with you gives me new sensations that are stimulating.
Well, bravo. Now, pour us some more wine.
Some more wine?
So, are you saying that you want to get back together?
Well, you have to admit that marriage sort of put a damper on some of our most secret desires.
Now start with a compliment.
Would you do me a favor?
Take her to bed. Tell her that she reawakened the beast in you.
Claudia, I don't know, but... I don't know, Claudia. I'm very inspired tonight. I think you're bringing out the beast in me.
Robert?
It's a fishbone. Roberto, svegliati! Mm. Wake up, huh? Are you forgetting about our plan?
No.
When you're supposed to say do this.
I was just thinking.
Thank you. Remember how warm we used to be in that old waterbed? Remember how we
used to wrap arms around each other?
Robert, do you think you'll ever find a way to write your novels and be happy with me at the same time?
Absolutely. Just let me be in charge this time.
Wait, I have to go to the bathroom.
Why?
I have to take something off first.
If you have anything to take off, I'll take it off. What's that?
Stay in the dark, al buio si fa l'amore.
What the devil is this stuff?
What the devil is that?
A beauty mask.
You know, you look like a ghost.
How could I work with an idiot like that, my doll? He is a completely psychoneurotic.
Oh, Giacomo, you are speaking very strangely.
But he treats her so badly. She's so tender. Claudia needs a real man. She's...
I know, Giacomo. Don't even think about it. Remember what happened last time, Giacomo, please.
I thought you wanted to be a writer.
I do, just not your way. I screwed up enough with Claudia already. I don't want to give any more mixed signals.
What if I told you that you can leave without really leaving? I mean, how do you say, have your cake and eat it too?
I don't think so. I don't need any more of your crazy ideas.
I understand. But this is something serious.
No, thank you.
Maybe it isn't too serious.
What?
I don't want to bother you with any more of my crazy ideas. It will change your life too much.
Maybe you don't understand. Change is what I need. I need change from all of this.
Maybe I have a solution.
Oh, Giacomo, are you doing this again?
I'm offering you the chance to trade places with me. Just temporarily. Just long enough for you to find the inspiration for your novel.
But you're dead. You're a ghost.
Yes, precisely. Think about the advantages. No longer slaver to your body. Pure mental energy.
Mental energy?
Yes. You can travel through time. Know everybody's secret. It is possible. I assure you. We can trade a place.
Mais non. Giacomo, pourquoi tu me fais ça?
Do you have any eyes? We need lots of eyes. The temperature has to go down to 32 degrees for you to leave your body.
Ryan, oh, I'm so cold. I'm freezing.
Roberto. You will feel better. Bravo.
You know, I'm starting to have second thoughts about this.
Bravo. Don't worry, Robert. You will feel much better. Much better.
Okay. I feel strange. Oh.
Maestro, tell me all of my powers.
Robert, you can materialize object. You can disappear, you can fly. You can turn into an animal, you can hunt a house, anything you want.
Really?
The only thing that is your limit is your imagination.
How come I can still see my body?
Your desire for physicality. Even the smallest result depend on the intensity of your desire. You can try something a little more original.
You're the human now. Who's the ghost now, huh?
My name is Roberto, eh?
What are you doing here?
I'm leaving.
Oh. Well, hurry it up. You know how Robert and Claudia feel about you being here, so hurry it up. I'm getting my medication.
I suggest that you stay like that.
Why?
Oh, to concentrate on your writing. Oh. Don't have to worry anymore about anything. No distraction. Don't forget about Claudia, the old man.
And then when I finish the novel, we'll trade places again.
Sure. But only when you finish. Huh? When you finish and you're published and you're famous, everybody respects you, you're gonna be like a prince. Believe in me.
Prince.
Robert, Robert, Robert. What are you still doing here?
Oh, I was just wondering, is it possible for me to travel through time as well?
Ah, Robert. Of course. You're a ghost.
You know, the colder it gets, the deeper these damn fleas burrow.
You got that right.
There's always our winter retreat.
Oh, my God. It was amazing. I went to ancient Rome, to Greece, to Babylonia. I saw the birth of civilization. I have to write down my experiences. This is going to be the best novel ever.
The doofus?
Always making fun of me behind my back. I'd say it's time for a little retribution.
I'm the Grim Reaper, Alex.
What'd you say?
Good morning. I'm happy. Have you guys seen Robert? No? He wouldn't have left without saying anything.
He asked me to tell you.
Go on.
That he hoped that one day you will forgive him.
He wouldn't have left without his typewriter.
I am sorry, right? Claudia.
Right?
I am so sorry.
Tilly, I hope his dreams come true. I really do, even if we can't be together.
Aw, that's my girl. Now you gotta make your dreams come true. And stop worrying about Robert. All you gotta do is shake that little ass of yours and paint. You'll be fine. Hey! I know that guy.
Vai, 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 bastardo, vieni qua, vieni qua.
Give it back to the lady. Now say you're sorry.
I'm very sorry, ma'am.
I hated to see a woman being taken advantage of. It drives me crazy with rage. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Wow. Who is that?
It's Jack, Grandpa's new assistant.
Uh-huh.
Maestro.
Rob. Oh, are you trying to give me a heart attack?
I need some professional advice. I need the example of true love. Something that even defies death.
Oh, Verona. 15 or 30, Romeo and Julieta.
No, 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 something real. Romeo and Juliet never existed.
Robert, why don't you try and find for yourself, eh? Bye. Bye. Bye.
What's the matter with Claudia?
Shh, 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 shh. She's sleeping.
Well, I can see that.
She's stressed, Pappy. Leave her alone.
Well, then let's get her to a room. This is no place for her to unstress. You be careful with that. That belonged to my grandfather. He used to make the canaries sing with that.
Come on.
me, Robert. You're right. Romeo and Juliet really did exist.
Robert, do you want everybody to see you?
I met Shakespeare, too.
That's very good, Robert. Very good.
I'm really ready to write now, but if I keep up all this bracket, I can't concentrate.
Melt some wax into your ears. It's a good old trusty method. Now go away. Crawl away.
Jack's got that Latin lover stuff down, doesn't he?
Hilly, you're not thinking about the... Hilly?
No. Come on, I see the way he looks at you. And the way you look at him. Aha, gotcha.
Opera tickets. I was planning on taking Claudia tonight, like I used to when she was a child.
Which opera?
Don Giovanni. You might like that.
Yeah. That famous thief of hearts, huh?
I suppose you haven't been to an opera, have you?
Festus, let's just say that's the one opera I always refused to see.
Get out of here!
Yeah.
Anyway, here, you take Claudia tonight. You have more...
What? No, Festus.
Yeah, you got more no. Please, take them.
Gracias, Festus. Gracias.
Why don't you take this? I gave it to Robert about a year ago for a present, but he never wore it.
Grazie.
Okay.
Oh. Silent. Silent! Stop torturing yourself with that thing. You've been at it for weeks now.
Maestro.
Robert. What happened to you?
Oh, I met the Marquis de Sade. Brilliant soul, and he's so misunderstood. If I could only find the modern equivalent for my novel, it'd be a great character.
What are you waiting for? Go. Travel. Create.
I have been. I wanted to show you what I've written to this point. I'm very proud of it. I want your opinion.
All right. Now, Robert. Festus told me that you never met your mother.
Yes, so?
Well, now that you're a ghost and you can travel, why don't you go and meet her?
I'm really not interested. I want you to read this.
Robert, when I was a ghost, going and see my mother was my favorite trip. I must have witnessed my birth at least 1,000 times. And the first time I nursed on my mother's breast, Robert, I must have seen that at least 100 times. Oh, such a woman was my mother.
Oh, it's too much.
No, I
can't go out.
No. We're going to the opera. You can afford to be dramatic.
This much?
Yes.
Okay.
In 1700, wearing a beauty mark on your cheek meant that you were married. But right above the lip meant that the damsel was looking for a husband. Did you know that?
No. Where did you learn all this stuff?
Oh, Claudia, the places I've been.
Jack, did you read the pages I gave you?
The pages? Robert, yes, I read the pages. It's beautiful.
I don't know. Are you sure? Because maybe a little something missing.
Robert, it is brilliant. You are a master. I keep up with the good work.
Thank you.
Jack!
Oh,
You are beautiful.
Thank you. We gotta go. The cab is waiting.
The cab? Yes.
Andiamo.
What's he doing?
Silent. Let's take those papers and get out of here. What do you got?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Really? He says that these pages are the nectar of true romance.
You called everybody over here to tell us
that?
Hey. Remember the discussion we had about the violence?
Yeah, shut up.
You shut up.
You shut up.
Let's you go. Shut up.
Will you shut up? Figured he found a pot of fettuccine alfredo or something.
He likes it. He really likes it. First time somebody really likes my work.
It's mine. I'm gonna get you again.
Che tu sei una birichina, eh? Vieni qua. Vieni qua, vieni qua, bella. Vieni, vieni.
Please, 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 just the last one.
Okay. But just one.
What does it mean when a man has beauty marks all over his face?
It means that he has many, many women.
Like Don Giovanni.
Don Giovanni, no. Don Giovanni was an amateur.
An amateur? I had so much fun tonight.
Oh, me too, my darling.
Giacomo, you must be patient. Good night.
Oh, you never learn your lesson.
Yes, who is it?
Sarah, it's Robert. Robert Zamboni.
Are you out of your mind? 6 a.m.
I know, but I finished it. I finally finished it, Sarah.
What?
My novel. Oh, you are going to love this. It is so great. I'm FedExing it right now to you.
You've gone too far this time, Robert. That's it.
I know you were less pathetic when you just used sign language. How many more months are going to have to go by before you finally give up?
Jack is amazing. He makes me feel so special.
Have you guys done it yet?
No.
Well, maybe that's why he chases you around like a little puppy dog.
What?
Nothing. Just kidding. Happy birthday.
Thank you.
That's so sweet.
It's impossible. A whole year's gone by. Giacomo! Giacomo, how is this possible? We just traded places. It seems like yesterday. What's going on?
Robert, relax.
Relax. What? 1 year ago, you have an entirely different sense of time. You see, you can be gone 2 seconds or 2 months. But what does it matter? Never grow old.
Yeah, doofus ain't coming back. I'll tell you that right now. Hey, it's tough enough for us. Imagine a pansy like him. We'd probably find him dead under some bridge somewhere.
Pipe down, you guys. I'm trying to enjoy my sardines.
Shut up, spider. I'll step on you.
Well, Robert, this is Sarah. You're impossible to get a hold of, old pal.
I have some great news for you, but I'd rather drop by and tell you in person.
Yes!
Open it.
A puppy. Oh, my God, how did you know? He's so cute.
Claudia, for you I would lasso the moon.
Oh, my God. Sarah. Jack, come on downstairs, quick.
I can hardly see you.
I'm right here. Come on, the publisher's here. Come on, hurry up. Are you coming?
Si.
There she is.
Hello, I'm looking for Robert Zamboni.
You are the publisher?
Yes.
And so beautiful.
Thank you.
Now, Robert, never let on a thing.
Well, where is that wild man?
That wild man is traveling around the world.
I feel terrible about how I underestimated him so.
Oh, nonsense. He's a free spirit. He appointed me his personal secretary while he's away.
Good.
Oh, I see. Well, then I'll tell you. We were so impressed with Robert's work that we've decided to put it into rush status. The first prints will be out next week.
Yes. You are absolutely beautiful.
The book is the most beautiful thing I've ever read.
$50,000. No. You are too generous.
Robert deserves every penny.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Would you like to stay for dinner? Oh, a little coffee.
No. I have to go. I'm arranging the publicity for the novel. We're going to release the largest number of copies in our company's history. It was nice to meet you.
Robert, she is a beautiful.
It's a miracle. It's a miracle. Oh, my God. It's a miracle. It is a miracle, Jack. Oh, my God. I have to tell Claudia. Oh, I'm going to tell the old man. I can't even. I'm going to tell the maid. Oh, my God. Let's trade back now. I'm ready now, Jack. Come on.
I'm afraid it's not possible, Robert.
What are you talking about? Come on, I want my body back.
How can you talk to me like this after all I've done for you?
We had a deal.
You didn't think I would let you come back, did you? You are so naive, Robert. I am in love with Claudia. She needs him.
She's my wife!
You divorced her, remember? Besides, I know how to take care of a woman like her. You were never able to because of your fears, because of your insecurity.
Claudia, it's me. Claudia, it's me, it's Robert. I never left the house. Claudia! Claudia, stop painting, I'm right here. I never left.
God.
Robert?
Oh, thank God, you can see me.
Robert. What are you doing over here? What are you doing eating carrots?
You named the dog Robert?
Don't marry her, Jack. Don't marry her. Don't.
Because I love you too. Because I love women. Because I love beauty. And I want to love you all.
Careful. You'll hurt somebody.
I don't want to hurt anybody. But I can't help it myself. Maybe I can change.
You will never change. just one big overgrown Casanova.
What?
Hey, hey, hey. It's okay. It's okay. I like you just the way you are.
I don't like this reputation. You see, maybe I can learn to be faithful, Claudia.
You are so naive.
No. I have too big of a heart. I've already been playing this part for far too long.
It's so beautiful.
I don't think we'll be needing the maid anymore because I can manage myself.
My darling, you are so selfless, so giving. But I don't want these beautiful hands to hold anything but your paintbrushes. And this ring.
Jack.
To you, my sweet love.
You didn't cry when I proposed. No!
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 No.
Forgive me, Jack. It's just that sometimes I still feel Robert's presence.
Ha!
It's so eerie in this house.
Then let's go away to Italy. We can get married there.
Yes, let's go to Venice.
Yes, we can sell everything and get out of here.
Okay.
Look at this. Lovers Flying High by Robert Zamboni. Who'd have thought? He did it!
I always thought that little genius would go far.
Hilly, I have to talk to you. I'm worried about Robert. I called the publishers. Nobody knows anything.
Let it go, Claudia. You're getting married, for Christ's sakes.
I was just concerned. That's all.
He's a big boy. He can take care of himself. If he was so disinterested in us before, imagine now that he's some literary maven.
You bastard, stop pretending you can't see me. Hey! That's my check. I'm not gonna give you a minute's rest. Not one second. I'm gonna haunt you. I'm gonna be over your shoulder till you change things back the way they were. Till you're in your grave.
Trigetta. So beautiful.
Forgive me, Grandpa. I really misjudged you.
Ciao, Festus. I want to talk to you about Claudia's future.
Don't listen to him, Grandpa.
Claudia and I are planning to get married and to move to Italy.
What if Robert decides to come back?
Don't worry. He won't.
Damn you.
I always misjudged him.
I don't think so, Festus. Robert never liked you very much.
I didn't make his life easy for him either, you know, Jack. Damn, I wish I could see him again so I could apologize to him. Look, I put his favorite books all the way up here, just to spite him.
Festus, please, can we talk about my proposal?
No, Jack, I'm sorry.
Please,
but that's my decision.
Festus, come down, Festus.
Festus, come down.
Come down.
In nomine Patri, Filii, and Spiritus Sancto. Amen.
Amen. Poor Grandpa.
Grandpa was a good man, Claudia. You know what he said before he died?
What?
Marry Claudia and make her happy.
Liar! He's lying!
Claudia, there are too many bad memories in this house. Too many ghosts to prevent us from being happy.
I think you're right, Jack.
Robert. At last, my dream is about to come true. I'll send you the completed documents the moment they're ready.
Thank you very much, Mr. Thompson.
You're very well.
I've never been jealous of Claudia. Until now.
The passion of your jealousy is so delicious. So exciting.
Yeah, who cares? Come on, take a ball, boys. Winter's long from over. Okay, grab that hoose. Let's get out of here.
Go ahead. This book's been the ruin of me. I don't deserve any respect. Go ahead and burn them all. I was a jerk.
That doofus was a jerk to us, and you two guys are defending him!
He says that Robert became a new person ever since the ghost came on the scene.
What? Silent knows about the ghost?
I don't want to hear that story again. I have had that stupid ghost right after here!
Are you a ghost like me?
Giacomo was supposed to help put your marriage back together. He was supposed to save us. Now I am condemned forever. I am a damned soul.
Oh,
How could you have allowed him to have free range of your home? Don't you know anything about Casanova?
Casanova. He said he was his writer.
Jack, please take me with you. Please.
How foolish to allow him to murder you.
Murder me?
He gave you something to drink that night, did he not? It was a poison. He's an expert with these things.
This is all my fault. Poor Claudia. Sweet Claudia. He'll destroy her. I can't let that happen.
You cannot speak to her. You cannot speak to anybody. Unless a medium calls you forth. Or else, you must find the body of someone who has just died.
I've always secretly loved you, Festus.
Sorry, Dolores. But hold that thought.
Ellie, where's Jack? I don't know. Where is Jack?
I don't know. Can you believe I'm getting married again?
No, I can't.
No one is getting married until I say so.
Oh, Grandpa.
It was Jack who pushed me down the ladder when I disapproved of your marriage.
Come sit down.
No, he's a cheat and a liar. Is this the man you want to marry?
Claudia. I can't explain.
No,
Claudia,
no,
Claudia.
No. Grandpa!
It's okay, it's okay. Don't worry. I know you are, you bastard.
Oh, somebody help! Oh, my God, Grandpa!
I'm all right. I'm all right. I'm all right. Robert still loves you.
Robert is gone.
Didn't you read his novel?
No.
Read the first page.
To the only woman of my life, Claudia.
Oh. You are all so pathetic. So pathetic. I am leaving. I don't need no money. I don't need anything.
Claudia, this is for you.
Oh, my God. You know where Robert is. You know where he is? Where is he, Grandpa? Did something happen to him? Grandpa, tell me where he is. I still love him.
What? Only true love can do this. Oh, Giacomo, you broke
sospera.
Sit down.
Do you want some ice?
Yes, yes.
Isabel, get some ice, please. It's in the freezer.
Isabel?
Oh.
Hello. Wait a minute. Where am I?
Where are you? We're in the bookstore. We were having a seance. The bookcase fire fell on you.
Claudia's birthday party.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
What year is this?
Call a doctor.
1994. Is this right?
Uh-huh. Yes.
This is right. Am I a great writer?
Yeah.
No. The truth.
Great.
No.
Yes.
Electricity's on.
I have something to show you.
Come on.
No. And void.
No, and void.
No, and void.
No, and void.
No, and
void. Robert, are you sure you're feeling okay?
I love you so much.
Well, maybe we should help clean up the mess.
Yeah. Oh, thank God. How do you feel, Festus? Does your arm still hurt right here when you lift it up?
Yes.
And right here on your knee, when you lift your right foot?
Yes. Oh. How do you know about that?
Oh, it doesn't matter. Just keep warm, my friend. Just keep warm.
Robert, are you okay?
I'm so okay. I think it just took a big bump on my head to make me realize what's really important in life. What's important is family. It's as important as you.
Oh, Robert. Is this for real?
Oh, it's so real, Emma.
Grandpa, are you crying?
Me cry? You know I don't cry. Now, both of you, get in your own bedroom. Before you lose your mood. And I want that grandchild.
Bravo, Giacomo. For a moment, I thought you had forgotten me.
I had to adopt a very complex strategy for it to work. It had to be true love. I had to be very, very convincing.
But of course, you are right. How foolish of me it was to think that you would be interested in that one. She's certainly not your type. What are you looking at?
Nothing. Earthly love. It is so exhausting.
Thank you.
with that kiss, true love shone through and shattered the bonds that held Casanova and Lavinia in their prison. And Casanova's soul was freed.
What is that?
It's a shooting star.
That's it. That's the end.
Your story is so lovely, so beautiful. I can see.
You can see?
I see the story you have told. The way you tell it makes the images so real. It's like I can actually see them all. It's very beautiful.
Would you like to see another sometime?
Yes. Yes, I would. That would be nice.